Ready? Oh, we're recording. Hey.
All right, you guys. Today we're gonna show you we got a lot of questions about the home cook set, so we wanted to show you what comes in the home cook set and how to cook it. So we're gonna start with the kanzai sukiyaki, the traditional kanzai sukiyaki set. A lot of you think that the kanzai sukiyaki set is a hot pot. It's not a like brothy hot pot like shabu shabu, but it's more of like a in between stir fried and soupy, I guess. Is there a word for that?
No.
No, okay.
So it's between...
Like it doesn't have like a broth for you to like have, but then it's not like totally stir fried either. So in the Kanzai Sukiyaki home cook set, you get our sukiyaki sauce, and we mark our we pack it and mark the date on it, so please always look for that. You get a how to cook recipe card, and it shows you on the back how to cook it,
step by step instructions. Yes.
And then, of course, you get the vegetable kit. It has a king oyster mushroom, some onions, some green onions, napa cabbage, and
chrysanthemum,
is it? Or tung ho, crown daisy. Like, there's so many names for this, but in Korean, it's called sukkat. But it's really good. It goes really well with the sukiyaki. And you get a good pack of meat, which we already have ready right here to show you guys. This is exactly the same amount. And you get yam noodles. There's a lots of name for this too. It's in Japanese, it's called konnyaku noodles, shirataki noodles. But yeah, it's yam noodles in English. So you get this. And also you get two small butter cubes. You get seared tofu and a udon noodle. So now, oh, and of course you get two different kinds of dipping sauce. I wish we could pack all the different kinds of dipping sauce that we regularly have on our buffet, but we aren't able to do that. So we're packing the two most
traditional
dipping sauce for sukiyaki and shabu shabu, which is the roasted sesame, which is called komatare in Japanese, and this is the ponzu sauce. It's citrusy, soy kind of sauce. This goes well with the vegetables, and this goes well with the meat, but I just like using this all the way. It's personal preference. All right, so Terrence is gonna help me with a camera, and I'm gonna show you how to cook. So you can use any kind of pot at home. I mean, it doesn't have to be, this is the only one we can use right now. It could be bigger. I recommend using a thinner, what do you call it? Less, like not a deep pan, like a
shallow
pan and wide one, because that's what's usually used. And then also, if you have like a Japanese nabe pot, that's actually the best. But if not, that's totally fine. Butter. Sorry, I should have had this ready. Me not wanting to touch the butter, but I guess I have to. Okay. Turn it off. Sorry. This pan is normally for a hot pot, that's why it's... And then you want to lay all the vegetables.